So, if you guys have a Samsung, okay, we just have a Samsung washer here that almost never, guys, finishes the spin cycle. It comes out of balance, it starts shaking really bad. We'll explain, guys, what causes that and how to fix it today. Most of the washers will be that way. It's about to start, so I want to show you what it feels like. And we just have one little bitty towel going inside, as you can see. So, not many clothes, it's not heavy, but listen now. Okay, you can see how violently it starts shaking, so we'll explain, guys, what causes that and why the washer stops. Hey guys, welcome back to Honest Product Review. In today's video, guys, we'll demonstrate if you guys have a Samsung washer that does not finish the spin cycle, guys, it gets out of balance, it's shaking violently, guys, when it's spinning the clothes. We'll explain, guys, what causes that and how to fix it. Now, we'll demonstrate on this Samsung model, but most of them will be that way. So stay with us and we'll explain, guys, how to do that and how to fix it and repair it, guys, for very cheap and instead of buying a new washer. So stay with us and that's what we'll be doing today, guys. So we have that Samsung washer now, guys. We removed the top cover, pretty simple. We just had two screws that we had to remove, okay, right here on top, two screws, and we pulled it up and then we slid it back. But we didn't find anything interesting here, guys. We have the springs that hold the whole assembly together, okay, one spring on the other side, you can see. But the shocks actually that we need to replace, guys, you have four of them, two on the back, two on the front, they're actually, guys, underneath the drum. So we need to disconnect everything, the water supply, guys, and before you even start on the washer, make sure you disconnect the power supply to make sure you don't have any electricity, because it can kill you, guys. Before you do anything, disconnect the water and power supply. So we'll go ahead and flip it upside down and show you what else we need to do. So as you can see, guys, we have the cold and hot water already disconnected. We're ready to continue. We're going to put it upside down and we're going to show you, guys, okay, what we need to do to get to those shocks that we need to replace. We have four of them, guys. So guys, check it out, that washer, we put it upside down. Now, the thing about it is practically you don't have to remove and disassemble anything, guys, super simple. Why? Because you have that big hole that you reach things through. And if you notice, you have four other holes, okay, with bolts, one here, one over there, that two on the back, two on the front. Each one of those is, guys, where you access the bolts for the shocks, guys. Okay, bolts for the shocks. You have four shocks. Two on the back, two on the front. Check it out. That's what the shock looks like. This is a rear one. This is a front one. And you have two more on the other side. But the way you remove and replace them, guys, just replacing one of them when we show you, that's how you replace all of them. But what I recommend, just replace one at a time so your drum does not fall, guys. So that's what we'll be doing, one at a time, and we'll show you what we need to do now. So 13 millimeter wrench, guys, and we're going to remove the bottom bolt of that rear left shock now, guys. If you know how to replace one of the shocks, you practically, guys, know how to do all of them. So we'll just demonstrate on one of them, guys. Okay, if you hear some weird noises coming, that's our dogs, guys. Now, check it out, how much thread locker. Okay, that's thread locker, guys. You need to apply one later. We will have the link in the description of the video below. We will share, guys, where we get the thread locker and the parts from. So if you need to buy new shocks, you can get them for very affordable price, guys. Okay. And very fast shipping as well. So one of the bolts is removed. Now we're working on the second one. In most cases, they may be different lengths, guys. Usually the top bolt is a little bit longer than the bottom bolt because it mounts to the plastic drum, so it needs to catch more area, guys, for everything to be stable and not to break off. But the bottom bolt is to metal mount, so that's why, okay, that's why it usually is a little bit shorter bolt. So we are about to remove it now, just a little bit left. Now, in most cases, the front and the rear, guys, shocks are different part numbers for some washers, but always verify that before you order the parts, because you don't want, guys, okay, to actually order the wrong parts. So, okay, we're removing the bolt by hand now. You can see it is longer than the other bolt, okay, way longer. So, grab that shock, pull it out. Okay, perfect. Now this is the shock, guys. Okay, this is shot, completely shot. Now what we have here, okay, the new one, part numbers are matching, okay, with the new one. Just one is yellow, one is white, Okay. And you can see when it starts, okay, how hard it goes after that. They do have some play, that's natural, but the total resistance should be way different, guys. So we'll go ahead, install it now. Okay, we'll just get the bottom bolt started by hand. Okay, we're starting the bottom bolt now. We're almost there. Okay, I think it was almost there. Yep, right there somewhere. And once we start it, guys, we'll go ahead and start the top one after that as well. So, okay, we have the little helper here trying to fix the other one while we're working on one of them, guys. So, we almost lost our wrench. So, we already started them, guys. So, all we have to do now, get the two bolts tight. Okay, get them tight. You can see we started both the top and the bottom one. And we're going to run the washer, guys, okay, and see how it runs and if anything improves after that. So we'll see if that takes care of the problem. So we'll go ahead and replace all four of them. We just showed you on one, but guys, exactly the rest of them are exactly the same way. So make sure you stay until the end to see if that fixed our problem. So what we did, guys, we put everything together, we replaced all four shocks, and now, guys, it's on spin cycle. Okay, let me turn the light on, and you can see, guys, that there is absolutely no vibration, and that definitely took care of our problem, and definitely, guys, a good working washer again. So hopefully that will take care of your problem. Thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel for more help, and see you guys next time.